Good afternoon, everyone. It's Wednesday. My plans of doing this in early in the morning never happen, so you see me in my wreckness. Every time I do this, I'm wrecked. I just spent probably an hour packing that damn, see the, not that, that this black thing here. I've spent an hour. There's the photos. Probably a good hour packing that up today. You'll see what it is in a minute. It took me about half an hour or so yesterday just to try and work out what to put it in and to jam it in there, and I broke something on it anyway. I told them and they're still going. I was hoping they'd change their mind and I'd refund them because it's, anyway, we're hoping it's not going to be more than 25 kilos. So for those who don't know me, who are new to this channel, please subscribe, please say hello, and please like this crazy video because that's what you get every time you watch me, is craziness. This is my shed right here. I am a eBay reseller. Well, I sell everywhere. I'll sell on Facebook Marketplace. I'll sell wherever. I've always had that little bit of reselling, thing in me. So I've always sold garage sales back before there was any this technology stuff. So I used to do it then as well. And I've been doing eBay on and off for many years as well. But I live in a bus usually. That's why I have a shed, not in my home, because if it was in my home, it'd be much easier. I live in a bus with my husband, grandkids, their friends, dog and a cat and two birds so far. Four grandkids. And if I didn't say that already. And we've been living in slop at the moment. So good news to all those who have been following me for a while. We are allowed to stay at where we are for another 3 weeks, but we were moved from the boggy area, which I tried a video yesterday and I lost it, but this is what we're parked now right here. We're slop where we were parked and we were going to get bogged, so we got out of there and he moved us to the other side so they can do some work on the other side where we were, and the circus can come back and be slodged out again. And so we're there for 3 weeks. We've got a reprieve of 3 weeks. Thankfully, I kept saying, please, universe, let me have three more weeks, or let me have some more time, because otherwise we'd have to be gone by tomorrow. We had nowhere to go. So, and I didn't want to go too far from the shed because the shed is awesome having it close by. So that's me. And I thank you for coming aboard and watching me. I had other videos. I actually had two other videos I was going to share with you, but I've ditched them because one's too old now, it's like last Friday or something, and the other one was Monday and it went too long, or yesterday. Anyway, they're gone. Good bye-byes, you won't see them, I don't think. So you missed out on all the rattling I did then. But I want to tell you a story first before I start what sold. Tell you a story. So if you've heard that, you know about my packaging. And now in my heading, I think I've got, what do I have? If I'd only known, I don't know what I was going to write there now. I had this really good heading. I don't know if I've used it. But I bought these awesome boots yesterday because, you know, we're really in a state where we need boots. Because when we walk out of our bus, we've got a pallet to stand on. But all around the bus is mud. Complete mud. Where he's parked is great. We're not going to get bogged there because the mud is just surface mud and it's hard underneath. But walking out and in and out. So I thought, oh, I was so excited about my boots. Look at them. Look at them. They're awesome. Until I was walking around Salvo's today and I felt something under my foot. I go, what the hell? And I walked a little bit further and then my piece fell off. There it is. I picked it up. These were hot hush puppies. Obviously, either I'd say the sole was too old because they're really comfortable and perfect for slipping on and off, or they don't like the mud, but I think that's the soles were just too old and I didn't test them. I like to test my shoes and I didn't test them because they're all cracking up. So yeah, I lost my shoes in the thing, and when I was leaving there was this lady sweeping the floor. She goes, oh, it looks like someone's shoes is breaking. When I said that was mine, I had to go to the car and put my other sandals on, because my thongs on, because I had nothing else. And yeah, I was really sad that I lost my $3 shoes. So yesterday I went to Yamba and McLean, and I actually had the best op shopping day, and I might share the video, I don't know, it probably goes too long, but I had a really good op shopping day yesterday and I got a lot of stuff. So anyway, so now we are here to do what's, oh no, I don't know if this is going to work because my video just cut out, you know, it does that thing. So we're going to do my quickly, I'm just going to get through that 1.5 or 2.5 minute thing again. I'm going to have to join this video up again. Anyway, we're going to do what sold now so you can see what I did. It was okay. It was okay week. It wasn't too bad. It's filled up, nearly filled up the page because there's a story in there too, because I like my stories. I did have to refund something from last week because these jeans here, I had the wrong heading. I had a different heading. I sent the jeans for the heading, but they weren't the jeans in the photo. So I had my two jeans mixed up photos. So the poor guy, he was so nice. He was so lovely. He's posting. I paid extra to post them back because it wasn't his fault. So poor guy missed out on the jeans that he wanted because they were too small and they weren't in there. You know the story. So be careful when you're listing. You don't mix your jeans or anything up with the wrong title. Okay. The first thing I saw was Scotch. Some of this is boring, guys. I don't even know if I should even share with you, but I'm going to share with you anyway. So you don't buy some of this garbage that I've bought in the past. I'm being I'm being much more careful. Much more careful with what I buy most of the time. Sometimes I'm not. But anyway, Scott Pilgrim DVD I bought ages ago. I probably paid 50 cents for it. $7.85 is what I got. And it's boring. Don't buy it. Just don't buy these. Just don't. I don't even want to dabble with CDs or DVDs unless I can do bulk or I can do like sets. I'm not dabbling in them anymore. The Lego, the Speed Lego, which I got from, and I saw the last sort of Lego, which I got from the op shop one day when it had just come in, and I got it really super cheap. Probably paid five. I didn't pay five. I probably paid only about $2 for this Lego. I'll say $5. Well, I could say free because I paid. Yeah. Anyway, I'm going to say $5. $35.31 is what I made. That was good. Corfu jeans I've had ages. Probably paid $4 at the max for those. Only $8.67. Why am I sharing this stuff? Don't buy them. Tales from Fern Hollow. I don't know. If you have a full set, yeah, get them. But if you don't bother because they sat for ages. I probably only paid $1 for those. And I made $12.50. Stone jeans. Yeah, they were pretty good. Like I didn't have them for a while. They only cost me about $4 max, I think. I'm going to cut off in a second. $13.22 is all I made because I've got my 35% on everything in my store other than new listings. Everything is 35% off because I want it gone because I was in a panic the other day because I didn't know where we were going to end up and I didn't want to have a big thing full of stuff I have to move again. Get ready for me to start this again in a second, guys. Ready, set, go. At least I know 2 minutes and 46 seconds it stops. Right. Burton Snow Pants, another good buy. That was from the $2 markets. Now, this is the second thing I've sold from that $2 lot, and I made another $23.61 on those. Arthur Spiderwick sat for a long time, then he was delisted. I've got a lot of stuff that I've just realized that aren't even listed anymore. I've got to go back and work out what they are so I can relist them. Anyway, but the Arthur Spiderwick, $20.84. I think I only probably spent like 50 cents or dollar on that, so $20.84, so he's pretty good. And Speedy Arthur the Spiderwick series is really good to get to. Batman Xbox game, only paid $1 for it, probably a week and a half ago. $10.77 I got for that. Patent tights, only paid $1 for those. Only made $6.55, but I made that plus my dollar back. The Wrangler ladies jeans I had for a while. No, I haven't had them very long, so I only paid maybe $4 for those. Made $24.20. The Zuzus, they just sat for so long. I actually threw a last one in with it, this lot. I only made $15, so it was okay. But I don't think I'd bother finding the Zuzus again unless a new in packet. I just don't know. It's good. I've learned a lot of stuff not to buy. The Bully Xbox game, also for $1 at the same time. I got the Batman Xbox game. $15.96 I made on that. Have I done that? Yeah. The Black Maiden shapewear, remember I paid $3 for that not long back. I made a profit of $22.65 for those. I don't know where I was up to. I'm going to go backward a little bit. So the Zuzu pets, I wouldn't buy again unless they were new and packet. The Bully game, yes, done that one. The Black Maiden shapewear, I think we passed that one. The sewing machine, here, right? Stupid sewing machine. Now, I bought it from the guy who was in the shed next to me at the Ballina Storage Sheds. Now, if I hadn't have got my stuff out when I did, which was about a week and a half to 2 weeks prior to the floods, this is where my stuff would be, right here. See all this? This is the poor people's stuff that had their stuff in storage. That's what's left of their stuff. That's what mine would have looked like. So I rescued this because I doubt his stuff would have survived. He had motorbikes and everything in his shed. Oh, I would have been heartbroken. I think he had a Harley and everything. I hope he got it out. Anyway, this... Never again. That's what the thing I was going to say. Never would I ever buy boots without checking the spaces. Never would I ever buy a sewing machine and put it on eBay. Never ever again. It's huge. It's heavy. I don't know. I'm hoping it's less than 25 kilo, 23 kilo. I think that's the max they take. Fingers crossed, tomorrow I'll find out. Anyway, $30 is what I paid for that. He paid $149 plus, he paid $30 postage, right? Now I'm going to add another $20 postage to that to make it $50 postage because I don't know. So if I did that, I've made $79.41. If I didn't do that, I'd make $99. But I'm really thinking it's going to be more than $30 to send there, way more than $30. So I've added a $20 on that for postage. So $79 profit. I should say about $10 of that is effort packing it. Another $5 worth of tape to get it together. It's horrific. Never again. Anyway, this Peter Lang necklace, and I feel really bad because I thought I'd post it. I told the lady I posted today and I realized I sent a messenger back to say I hadn't posted it. I was meant to, but teens got in my way. But this Peter Lang necklace cost me nothing. Now, this was in the... We're getting less time now, guys. It's going to 2 minutes. This Peter Lang necklace I got in the 50-cent bag of jewelry. I think it was the very, very, very first bag of jewelry I got. It was on the desk when I walked in and I grabbed it. And this was one of the many things, along with some white gold, a white gold ring and a few other bits and pieces. Now, I didn't pay anything for it. And it's been sitting for a hell of a long time. I had it a lot higher because this Peter Lang is quite well known. But I did make $27.79 on something that I didn't really pay anything for. Gok underwear I got for free when someone was throwing out their stuff. I only made $8.35, but I'm happy with that because it's all profit. The men's R.M. Williams jeans I only paid $4 for at the max. Might not have been four. Actually, you know what? They were a dollar. I just remember because they were from the op shop. They were a dollar. So I made actually more money than that. So I made $38.45 on that, but I didn't put it all in there. This, the Knockout Paper Punch right here, I paid $8 for a few months ago. Finally sold it on my 35% off. So I made $17.54 on the Knockout Paper Punch. It better work. Now, the EPNS bangle, I sold it yesterday, and I'm kicking myself I didn't delist it because it's a beautiful vintage bangle. It was ex-shop stock, and I should have kept it as a gift for somebody. It would have saved me some money later down the track. But anyway, I only paid $3.50 with a whole bundle of them at one time, but I'm still kicking myself that I didn't remove it from my listings, and I only made $16.42. So, yeah, bummer. Now, I'm going to have a little bit of a vent because this guy... The other day, I woke up to two or three offers. And I went, beauty, I'm taking all offers. I don't care if I've got 30% off, whatever I've got off, I'm taking offers too, right? Unless they're ridiculously low. So he wanted this Dreamgirls thing, and I said, okay. Then the other offer was on these vintage matches, which have got Nudie Rudies in it as well. So the vintage 70s Nudie Rudy matches, a few of them. And then someone offered the T-Jet game. They offered me money for that, which I said yes. Then this Commonwealth book of the Olympic Games, which was a very low offer, but I took it. And then this Bush Bashers book here. Okay, I took them all. And no paying. And I'm thinking, why haven't they paid yet? So I checked out the name, and each of them has the same stupid person's name there. In the US. Now, even though I checked the name, I'm going to go off in a second, his buying feedback has been great. But for me, nothing. So I'm actually going to be telling eBay about this fellow, and I'm going to actually send them, what I did the other day, I messaged them and I said, would you like me to do up an invoice to have it all together? Because they're in the US, like I have nothing overseas, not a thing. And I've heard nothing. So I'm going to message eBay later, which I'm going to try and do before they close tonight, and tell them, can they please, you know, I'm going to delete these and tell them why, because it's so frustrating. Now, that's it for me. Now, other than that, I didn't take away the refund of jeans, so it's more for my accountant. But my profit would have been $4.57 thereabouts if that guy had paid, which is still over the $400, which, you know, we're still doing the 400, so eventually I'm hoping to get over the five. But $402.01 is what I made this week, and I didn't add anything else up for you guys. I don't know what the fees. Oh yes, $80 everything cost me because I had this monster in here, which was 30. So $80 is what I spent for $402 profit. And yeah, I think we're still there. And that's it. That's what I did. So guys, thank you for watching. If this isn't a two, if this video doesn't go if it's short enough, I'll add some more in the back of what I've got yesterday or the last week, whatever, just to entertain you all. But otherwise, other than that, I will see you again soon. I'm going to go before it goes off because it's about to go off again. So take care, everybody. It's probably all I had to say to you anyway. See you next time. And happy treasure hunting. And wish me luck on my treasure hunting because I do need more stock because I am down to the dribs and drabs. I'm nearly empty of anything to list. It's all little tiny pieces. I'm going to keep talking till it goes. So I'm going. Bye.